Absolutely stunning. What a tremendous routine. Go on, give her a big round of applause. She exits the arena. And as you'll no doubt see, all the handlers will try and dress to match their routine, or, as it may be in that case, in their own country's national dress. So if there's something going on you can't quite see because the handler's got the back to you, don't forget the camera will be zooming in on the big screens and you can flick your eyes up there and have a look what you might be missing. We're getting a little replay now. It's a great sport, it all involves dog training and it's not just about dancing to music. Before you get there, you have to actually teach all the tricks. And I said earlier, the dog activities, that you can actually get your dog to teach them a lot of little tricks at home. The big hurdle to climb then is choreography to music, which is where all that routine comes in. You can't just do a series of tricks. It's supposed to be about a very nice, eloquent routine. It's not just doggy dancing either. It's getting it all choreographed in correctly. Anyway, we've got the scores up. Oh, look at this content. 9.2. Oh, this is off to a good start. 8.9 for accuracy. Oh, nearly got a naught then. And this is musical interpretation, folks. 9.3, 9.5. 9.2. Nothing to deduct. 27.57. That's out of a total of 30 marks. I just better mention that each judge has 10 marks in each section. That is, because we've got three judges, it's divided by three and we come up with the average. And I can tell you folks, that's very, very, very high. So let's hope that's a sign of the standards coming the rest of the competition. Now, we've got the next handler representing the Netherlands. Yes, we've got something from the Netherlands. Now, you have to apologise if I get pronunciation wrong. It's Saskia de Graaf. She's got her dog Sheena. Kennel Club name is Rosalind Corrigan Akvan, a border collie 8 years old, and she's going to be performing to the Harry Potter song. So Harry Potter will be zooming him on his broomstick any moment now. as soon as she gets set up. So it's music maestro, please.
When I call your name, you will come forth. I shall place the sorting hat on your head, and you will be sorted into your house. They are Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw, and Slytherin.
Harry Potter!
I know just what to do with you. Gryffindor! Well done, Saskia. Saskia Graf and Shayna, representing the Netherlands, or we should call her Mrs. Harry Potter. Well done. Well, it's going to be a busy day today with good routines on scene. That's another good one for the judges to ponder over. I did say, give it a round of applause, she leaves. Well done. I did say about the marking, as I said, each judge is marking out of 10, and there are 3 sets of results for each section. The first one being content. They must have, you can't go in and just repeat the same move all the time, keep leg weaving. You need a good selection of content, different moves,
and also not repeated too often. So a good selection of moves. So that's the first mark, that mark out of 10. Secondly, it's accuracy. Whatever moves they make, were they entirely accurate, or did the dog miss a trick? Did it miss backing up into the right position, etc.? And thirdly, one of my favourites, really, and I think it's most important, it's musical interpretation. It's does it fit the music correctly? It's not just about doing a series of tricks where there happens to be music playing in the background. You've got to get the choreography right. It's not, I know we call it dancing with dogs, it's not dancing with dogs. What it is doing a really well choreographed routine. So that's what the handlers are looking for, that's what the judges are looking for. Right, I think we're ready for results, and it's another good one. 8.9 and 9 for content. 8.9, 9.1, and 9 again for accuracy. Was a good routine, folks. And the musical interpretation was excellent. And it's 9.067 altogether. No deduction for Roger, and then 27.03. That's just behind the leader, but in actual fact, it's just a signal that the standard is going to be pretty high today. Right, judges, are we ready? Is you stretching your minds a bit? Two good ones to start. Now, running third. Have we got anybody here from Switzerland? Just a few. They're obviously back because they know how to keep a low profile. Would you welcome in from Switzerland, Claudia Moser with Tilly? The Kennel Club name of the dog is Jimmy Jewel, 6-year-old border collie. They're going to be forming, oh, we're going up market a little bit here, folks, because in Switzerland is the Blue Danube by the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra. That's the music they've chosen. Perhaps we've got a little bit of a clue from the theme of the routine, from what's happening there. Anyway, the floor is yours, Claudia.
Thank you.
absolutely stunning routine, some tremendous pieces in that. And the bow at the end. Give her a big round of applause, she leaves the arena. There's some tremendous, well-trained piece in there. Obviously, with all doggy people, you know how difficult it is to train your dog to do a complete circle that far away from you. It is very difficult, because all the dog wants to do is come back into you. Anyway, we'll try and give you a bit of background to things as we go along while the judges are making up their minds what their marks are going to be. And it does get more difficult, obviously, as the competition progresses. Fairly recent sport, just started in 1990 with a little demonstration in Bedfordshire. And someone did a Heelwork, obedience Heelwork round with music playing. That person was a very young Mary Ray. And the audience went away and said Mary did Heelwork to music. And she did it again in 92. It came here as a demonstration, and sometime in between, it was thought perhaps it had better be choreographed. And that was how Heelwork to music started, just like that. Although people had trained with music playing for many years, that was the first really formal event. Anyway, here we are, the marking content. 7.9, 8.5 and 8.6. That's still really, I know we're not in the nines, folks. That's still a really high mark. There's only 10 maximum. We've got 8, 8.9, 8.7 on accuracy and musical interpretation. 7.8, 8.8. The last judge can't make a bit more. We're just checking the score. We think it's 8.5, and then we're checking that now with the judge. Was it 8.5? 8. Here we go. Five, all the noise there. 25.10. Give a big round of applause, Claudia Moser. A really cracking routine that was. But we must move on. Into third place she goes. Now, anybody here from Scotland? Well, you'd like to welcome in Jeanette Fife then with Ziggy. And a different breed, we've got a golden retriever. Kennel Club Racing name, Raincorn Zig Philly. And Ziggy's a 7-year-old retriever, as you can see. And we're going to mark it a little bit with the music again, because it's Strictly Come Dancing, folks. And, ready and gets into position. So Jeanette, Fife and Ziggy with Strictly Come Dancing, and the floor is Jeanette's.
Feeling hot, hot, hot.
Well, what did you think about that? Jeanette, that was cracking. And what about that golden retriever, folks? Isn't it great? Full of life, clever, a really great dog, that. So there you go, the good stuff continues. I'll tell you, we got a really good standing in this competition today, and I've been looking at Heelwork music for many years, and this is a really great competition. I'm really enjoying it myself. Right, that's a Scottish competitor. What was I saying? So it started in 2000 with a little demonstration, stopped at Crufts for 2 or 3 years, wasn't really going the next step up. So Rugby Dog Training Club decided to hold the first Heelwork to Music competition in 1996. And that sort of gave it the leg up to the next level. And now there are dozens of competitions in the UK, and I can tell you it's everywhere in the world. I know we've got some Heelwork to Music judges from Australia with us somewhere. There they are. And it's in Australia, New Zealand, Japan, it's just about everywhere. South Korea, America, all throughout Europe. And you know that because of the countries we've got competing. Right, here we go. Results for that Jeanette and that lovely retriever. So, content, 7, 7, 8, 5 and 8, 4. 7, 3, 8, 7. And 7, 6 for accuracy. And musical interpretation, 8, 5, 8, 7. And 8-4. That's a really good result. There's nothing to take off. 24.6. I have to say, folks, that anything above 7 is classed as really, really good. It's just that the standard in this class is really very, very high. Into fourth place she goes. Now, next into the arena. Is there anybody here from Belgium? Looks like a coach pulled up outside. Would you like to welcome from Belgium, Hans Krebs with Spotty? And the Kennel Club registered name of the dog, it's a WSD. It's WSD Spotlight Spotty. Border Collie, 5 years old. And, right, I might give you a bit of a clue to the music here. The music is Beauty and the Beast by Celine Dion. Pablo Bray, or something of the sort. Anyway, it's Beauty and the Beast, Hans.
Ever as before, and there
raise the roof, folks. Belgium and Hungary.
Well, it just gets better and better, this does. The sport itself is mainly dominated by the girls, you know. And we've actually very lucky. We've got just two men in today's competitions. You've just seen one of another one to come later. And hope this encourages a few more guys to have a go, because you can do something very special with a dog, as you can see. Right, we're waiting for our judges to make their minds up. All this starts with a few tricks, you know. You just got to train a few tricks. You can do it in the living room at home. You can join a dog training club. And then just the trick is to put them to music. I know my wife has 15 minutes, 10 or 15 minutes with several of the dogs every morning. She trains with a clicker. All the training is done hands off. You cannot force a dog to do this. The dog has to want to do it because he's enjoying it. And as we know, all dogs want to do something. There are very few breeds that don't want to do anything. Well, except perhaps my lurcher, but there you go, that's another story. But in actual fact, all breeds want to do something. They've got brains, and this just exercises the brains a little. You can do a bit of training at home, then all you got to do is put it to music. It's great fun, even if you don't want to compete. Right, we're ready with the result now, just being handed in. Nine, oh, here we go, 9.1. That's for content. Accuracy, 8.589 and another 9. Now, musical interpretation, I thought it was good. 9.5, 9.2, and 9.3. Any deductions? No, 27.7. What a tremendous result. Into second place for Belgium. Now, our next routine. Anybody here from Denmark? Yes, we've got some supporters. Welcome into the arena, representing Denmark, Joanna Alanak. With her Border Collie soda. Kennel Club registered name, Kadima e Physical Graffiti. That's the Kennel Club registered name. And the music she's using, it's by John Williams, and it's the Indiana Jones theme. First time in this competition for Joanna Soda. And when she gives a signal, it'll start. We'll be right back.
Give a big round of applause, Joanna, at the Indiana Jones theme. Well done, Joanna. Another great routine. Especially with the golden egg. Well, that was Denmark competing. We normally have a winning scores around anything between 22 and 24 points, something, say up to 25 maximum. The leader at the moment is on 27.57. Running in second place, 27.17. Running in third place, 27.03. That's the standard we've got so far. And we've got some beautifully engraved crystal for the first three in this competition. So everything to go for. Hello, here we go. Props are out. So we're just waiting for the reels to come in on this. And we'll move on to our next country. We've had 3 days of finals here. So we had the freestyle, the Heelwork music, and now the international. We've got a couple of demonstrations tomorrow, and I think just before Best in Show, around 8 o'clock on Sunday night, Mary Rowe will be performing her routine here in the main ring. And we still have a few tickets available for the main ring Sunday night. So you've got actually 3 ways of watching what happens on Best in Show night. You can either come here and watch it in person, there's a few tickets available. Or the scores are up. Content, 8. 8.6 and 8.1, that's an excellent result, all above 8. 7.8 for accuracy, an 8.7 and a 7.5, given the average there of 8, so that's still an excellent result. And musical interpretation, that's going to be 8 as well for the 3. Any deductions? 0.75, could be a bar, but on it, so it could be a touch. So there is a deduction there. Still a good result there for Denmark and Joanna. 23.65. Right, ready for our next time lap? Anybody here from Wales? Just a few. Oh, see a flag waving up there. Well, representing Wales in viewing now, we've got Michelle Hubbard with Z. Let's give her a nice welcome. The Kennel Club mission name of the dog, Tumbler Twisted to Little Jack Russell. 9-year-old Jack Russell. His full name's Tumble Twist, his Kennel Club mission name. He's actually, his friends call him Z. And this should be interesting. The very posh orchestra this routine is from is called the Wurzels, and it's Farmer Bill's Cowman.
La 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 la, oh ah, oh ah, ah. They call me Farmer Bill's Cowman. La 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 la. topic. In spite of the sight, I keep smiling. In blooming for sight, I loved her all right. When she were engaged to the plowman. Now I'm her deaf and their Somerset millionaire.
Michelle from Wales with a really gay little Jack Russell Z. What a fabulous fun routine. Well done, Michelle. So you can use any reader dog. It's just about having fun with your dog. And that's what it's all about. Owning a dog is having fun with it as well as doing a bit of something serious like training. So again, we're just waiting for the judges to make up their minds. We've got a special event coming up this summer because we have, as I did say, how popular it's getting now. We've got the first ever World Championships for Heelwork Music going to be held in Denmark. The big continental organisation called the FCI, which a lot of you I'm sure have heard of, are going to have a FCI World Championship. We already sent a team to the FCI Agility World Championship, so we're now going to go for the FCI Heelwork Music. A team's going over to represent Team GB, Great Britain. And they'll be competing, I think it's in June. And our centre judge here is on the team as well, as being team manager. She'll be competing there. Let's give her a round of applause, representing Great Britain. The bad news, of course, for the team manager and team member is now she's now watching what some of the competition is. Might not be quite so easy, I don't know. It's going to be a very tough world championship, that is a fact. Here we go, Michelle Hubbard for Wales. The very game little Jack. 7.9. This is content. 8. So it's a good amount of good number for content there. 7.867 in total. Accuracy. Did he get it all right? 7.5, 8.1, 7.3. The judges obviously decide where their level's going to be throughout the whole marketing process. So in musical interpretation was a good one. 8.3, 8.3, and 1.7. There is a deduction there. 1 point. May have helped the dog, it might have been a bar. I don't know, I didn't see it without looking very carefully. Give her a big round of applause. 22.75, that is a very, very respectable mark. Now, anybody here from Sweden?
Yeah!
Well, we've got our handler from Sweden coming into the arena now. It's Frida Burnett with Poppy. Let's give her a big round of applause. And very colourful too. Poppy's a border collie, 3.5 years old. And we're going to do a bit of rocking, folks. It's status quo and it's rocking all over the world. No, I'm not going to be jiving on the starline. Come on!
Well, folks, is that a finish or is that a finish? Stunning! Well done, Frieda. Stunning routine and a stunning finish. Give it a big round of applause. Frieda be there for Speedon. That's another great routine. It's just a very tough competition, this extremely tough competition. If you're interested in Heelwork to music or any of the activity sports, please do go up to Hall 3. We've got an activities area there. We've got experts in every one of the activity sports: obedience, agility, working trials, gun dogs, Heelwork to music, bloodhounds. You can have a chat with them. They're doing little demonstrations. If you want any, ask any questions in detail about how you can get started, where you can get some training, how they're trained, all the questions will be answered in Hall 3 at the Activity Centre. That's what it's all about, how the dogs manage to do what they do and how you can start and join them. So please do go up to Hall 3. That's what it's all about. And don't forget that if you can't be with us tomorrow or this evening, you can always catch up. Everything on this arena is going out live, streamed directly through the Crufts website. I think it's www.dfscrufts.tv. If you have difficulty, just do a search on Crufts website. www.dfscrufts.tv, and you can go live what's happening here. I also understand we've still got just a few Best in Show tickets left for Sunday night, as we have additional seating now. So if you'd like to be in on the action live, a full evening with everything happening from Best in Show to agility finals to Mary Ray's Lady Steelway to music routine, get your ticket for Best in Show. Right, Frieda Burnett, content 8285 and 83. Given a total of 8.333. Accuracy 7.9, 8.2 and 7.5. And interpretation of the music 8.378 and 8.3. Is there any deductions? Just 0.20, well, we've got it. 24.27, give her a big round of applause. That's Frieda Burnett for Sweden. And again, a very, very respectable mark. Now, next young lady competing, she's no stranger to these shores. She's competes on a regular basis. Anybody here from Jersey? Would you like to welcome into the arena, representing Jersey, it's Danelle De Guy with Bieber. Kennel Club registered name is Iacca, one step ahead for Bieber, 8-year-old working sheepdog. And she's going to be performing to Joseph. Hasn't got where the music came from, so all I can tell you is the name of the music, and it's Joseph. Very colourful outfit. So the floor is yours, Janelda.
about over an hour. Put all the things that were a stand as a helmet, 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 helmet. Well, the streamers got my baffled. Hey, Jules, tell me what it means. Yeah! Well, you know that kills and stupid. I don't have a clue. Don't make rules yourself.
Another great routine, Denelda. Denelda Guy, representing Jersey. Denelda been in Heelwork to music for many, many, many years. She was one of the early pioneers and stayed professional as ever and still doing a great routine. Give her a final round of applause. Denelda Guy with Bieber from Jersey. Right, once more, we're waiting for the judges to deliberate. And just a replay of Denelda's routine on the screen there. Say a little bit about deductions. Hello, looks like a little bit of high fashion coming into the arena. I'll have to try and concentrate on the screen. A little bit about deductions. Deductions are there for the judges to obviously deduct for things that they think may have had a bad effect on the routine. Now, it could be the handler physically helping the dog with their body. It could be barking. It could be execution moves that are not too smooth or moves that they indeed do not like. So that is where the deductions come in. So that we don't know what the judges are deducting it for. The competitors can ask afterwards and they will be told. But so that's a little place that the judges can cover all the little odds and sods that they want to move out of the way. So, right, now we're ready to go, I think, with our next competitor. But first we're going to have the result for Denelda Guy from Jersey. It's 8.3, 8.8 and 8.6, giving a total of 8.567. 8.7 and 8.9. I don't think she'll be taking first place, but it's a good result. Interpretation of music, 7.4, 8.5, and 8.8. No deductions there, 25.33, and puts her into fourth place. So it's a very high place there for Denelda. Well done. Just to have the trophies at the moment. Next competitor. Have we got anybody here from Germany? Oh, we've got some people from Germany. Good, because you'll want to support the representative from Germany, Mika Kebel-Hake. A dog's called Luna. The Kennel Club name is Perfect Luna. And as you can see, it's a Labrador, 6 years old. And some of you older people, myself included really, will know the music quite well, because it's Time Warp, the good old disco favourite. Get the dog settled, and our music technician is at the ready and waiting for the sign from the handler.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely.
Not for very much longer.
I've got to keep control.
jump to the left.
And then a stretch to the right.
With your hands on your hips.
You bring your knees inside. There is the pelvic thrust. It really does you insane. Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again.
It's so dreamy. Oh, fantasy free me. So you can't see me. No, not at all. Another dimension with voyeuristic intention. Well secluded, I see all.
With a bit of a mind flip,
you're into the time slip.
And nothing can ever be the same.
You're spaced out on sensation,
like you're under sedation.
Fact, folks, I don't quite know what to say, but you've probably just witnessed something in the crossfade ring you may never see again. And I can give you a little, let you into a secret. They've just carried out one of the Crufts General Committee members on a stretcher. Well done, Mike. You've cheered everybody up, especially the men. The only good thing I can say, of course, is that it's a good job we've got female judges. Otherwise, we know who'd have won the class. So there you go. We don't normally have routines like that in the UK although I can't remember a few years ago somebody did the stripper routine, but perhaps not quite so outgoing. Anyway, that's what you get, variety. And certainly we've seen some variety today. We've seen some stunning routines. And now, I think you should do something about their white legs myself, I don't know. Obviously a stranger to the tanning salon. Right, we're just waiting for the results. That was a stunning routine though, it was excellent. We'll see what the judges make of it. Certainly different, and all different kinds of breeds throughout the world. Work dogs in here, work to music. You haven't just got to have a collie, as you can see. Another different breed there, working that one. So, results are in. We'll see how high up that one goes, and then we'll move on. We've still got two or three dogs to go. In actual fact, we've still got three. Oh, 7.8. Judges, what are you doing? 8.7 and 8.5. Oh, 7.7. All right, which one's that? 8.6. Now, at the end of this, we want the response from the men to these marks. 25.2 for Minkum of Germany. What do you think of the judges, Ben? I'm probably going to get told off for this. I don't think we're supposed to do this in the main ring at DFS Golf, but there you go. Right, we're on to the next routine, and we've got a stunning routine for you now. Is there anybody here from England? Because we've got young Richard Curtis with us with Pogo. And the full name of the dog is Dance Floor Diva, and you'll see why shortly. And Richard's going to tell us a story. And in actual fact, the story's from Hawaii 5-0. So representing England, Richard Curtis and Pogo. We'll be right back. It is a tremendous routine, and we are majority English, I would think, in here. But don't forget, the judges have a different agenda. They are marking two very strict criteria. So because it's the most entertaining, it might not necessarily be the winner. We've got to wait and see what marks the judges give. But it's certainly a very entertaining routine. I can tell you, folks, I said earlier, I've been doing this for a long time in Heelwork music, and I've watched it grow from 1990. And this is one of the best standards of competition I've ever seen. We've had some tremendous routines. If you joined us a bit late, you've missed something really, really special today in the early routines. So, again, we're just waiting for the judges to complete that. The lead judge in the middle has finished hers. We've got some great agility coming up following this, but please, when we finish, don't leave your seats. We've only got a couple of dogs more, because we've got the presentation of awards, and it is a special presentation. It is an international event. So we are going to parade all the handlers into the arena, and we'd really like you to keep your seats for the presentation of awards. Here we go, Richard Curtis. Content 995 and 98. Accuracy 89, 91 and 89. This is going to be close. Hungary's in the lead at the moment. Interpretation of the music 9.94. What's the last one going to be? 9.9. Deduction nil, 27.83. Into the lead he goes. What a great result for England. I'll tell you though, only just, it's a good job England have got a really stunning routine, because some of the others have been very, very close behind. In second place at the moment is 27.57, in third place 27.17, in fourth place 27.03. So in actual fact, we've still just got two routines to go. The next one, is there anybody here from France? Yes, we've got some French supporters. Oh, now I've got to get this name right now. It's Latita Gonon from France with Speedy. The Kennel Club is to name the dog is Let's Go Speedy. It's a two-year-old working sheepdog. And she's going to be performing a little bit of a clue in the dress again, I think. It's by Michael Jackson and it's Billie Jean. So, Letita, the floor's yours. Yeah. Give a big round of applause for Francis Letizia. Go on. With Speedy. Well done. Super routine to Billie Jean. Well, folks, we've only got one more to go to the end of this competition. And everybody's coming up to me and saying it's the best competition I've ever seen, and it surely is. A bit later on, we'll be seeing the person who came second in this competition in this arena a bit later this afternoon. And during the evening performance tonight, I think we invite the person who wins it to perform in the arena. So still a couple of chances to see those routines again. Hello, what was that? Hello, looks like the fire chief's in. So, final time, if you're interested in training any of the bits that go with Heelwork to music, or obedience, agility, gun dogs, anything, then please do go up to the activities area in Hall 3. If you're not with us for the remainder of the show, which is tomorrow now or later today, you can watch it live streamed on to the DFS Crofts website. It is on television tonight from 7:30, I think it is, to 8:30 for 1 hour tonight. And tomorrow evening it's 7 to 9, and that is a 2 hour programme. Now, the results for France, a 7, an 8.5, and a 7.7. Very respectable mark there. One of the judges downmarked us slightly on the accuracy to 6, but still the rest a good mark. 7.5, 8.8, and a 7.6. No deduction, no. Total 22.97 for France. Now, I think this is our final competitor in this afternoon's competition. Is anybody here from the Czech Republic? Oh, is that noisy ones up there again? Right, representing the Czech Republic, we have Elena Smolikova. Big Kisi. Dapper Dane Black Cheevers is the Kennel Club Mission Day of the Dog. It's a 7-year-old Border Collie. And I'm sure this one will appeal to our Welsh competitor. The record she's using is by Bonnie Tyler. And it's I Need a Hero. So it's a good thumping tune for us to go out on with our last competitor. So Elena, representing the Czech Republic. The floor is yours. now. Elena Smolikova from the Czech Republic. Come on, give it a final round of applause. She exits out the arena. Certainly a few different things there.